This is a video on the 7-octave system for minor pentatonic with the theme to I'm Your Hoochie Coochie Man. First, as background, let's review the 5 minor pentatonic fingerings. Fingering 1, notice 2 notes per string, notes on every string at this fret, the 5th fret. And here in a question mark shape at the 8th and 7th fret, which is like holding a G chord but barring down the first finger on strings 5, 4, 3. Putting those two shapes together builds fingering 1. Then fingering 2 is playing from the body side of that fingering, this G chord shape, for the left side of your hand, the head side of your hand, and on the right side of your hand, the body side, body of the guitar side, on the 10th fret, there's a note on every string except its 3rd string low. So this line of notes has the 3rd string low, as you just saw right there. And that fingering too, the most complex of the 5 pentatonic scale fingerings, goes like this. That's fingering 2. Then fingering 3 takes that line that was on the right, puts it on the head side of your guitar, and use your first finger in this fingering on the 10th fret, except 1 fret low on the 3rd string, and the 3rd finger on every string on the 12th fret, except little finger 1 fret high on the 2nd string. So these two lines, 3rd low at the 10th fret, and this line, 2nd string high at the 12th fret, make fingering 3. Finger it all with the 1st and 3rd fingers, except this note. Okay, now for fingering 4. A simple way to conceive fingering 4 would be play fingering 1, in this case an E minor here, the same as we played for A minor back here. But up here it would be E minor, but then change these two notes that are in a C shape, like the roots of a C chord, are up 1 fret. So watch for those two notes as I play the scale, changing from this note to this note, and changing that note to that note. So E minor has this, and A minor, fingering 4, has this. So that's fingering 4. And the head side of fingering 4 here at the 12th fret is a note on every string at the 12th fret except 1 fret high on the 2nd string. And on the body side of this one, everything's on the 15th fret here, except you have low by 1 fret right there on the 4th and 3rd string. And putting those together is another way to conceive this fingering 4. Then take this side that we just played with the 3rd and 4th fingers, and play them instead, fret them with the 2nd and 1st fingers, or 1st finger like this. So again, you have every string on the 15th fret, except 4th and 3rd string are 1 fret low, like this. And the body side of this is simply every note at the 17th fret, because it's this line we started with. The barring at the 5th fret is now at the 17th, 12 frets higher, with the 3rd finger. So here's fingering five. Remember third and fourth low by a fret. Otherwise, all on these two frets. And you could play that down an octave here, down 12 frets. And you might change the fingering in the bass instead of this. Since the frets are so spread down here, there's so much space between the frets, that you might use the second and fourth fingers in the bass like this. And then back to the first and third on the top. So all five fingerings, one. Fingering two, all in A minor. Fingering three, third low, second high. Fingering four, same as fingering one, but these two notes are a fret high, making it the same as having this line with second high, and this line with fourth and third low. And here's fingering four. Then fingering five is all at the 15th and 17th frets, except you have third and fourth low like this. And then that last line, all notes on the 17th fret, if you played up here, fingering one would be that with your first finger, playing fingering one as you began with again. Now, use those fingerings to play in seven octaves. And when you look at the pentatonic seven octave forward and backslash system, and then click on minor pentatonic themes in it, this is the first theme. But when you read the first example, I'm your Hoochie Coochie Man, leave out the notes in parentheses and you'll just get this. So be oriented to where the octave, the low octave bass note is in each one. I'm playing it where it's the index finger in the sixth string, index finger in the fifth string, A, fifth string A, index finger in the fourth string A. I'll replay all these slower in a moment. Then index finger in the third string A. So I had sixth string A, fifth string A, fourth string A, third string A, with the first finger as the low octave bass note. Now I want to use the little or ring finger for these last three, which span an octave that skips two frets and two strings initially. And the scale goes again. It's important that I just play that one octave scale so you can compare the octaves in all these fingerings. And that's here. And then third finger on the fifth string A. Then third finger on the fourth string A. Now here's the detail. So the first fingering, we want these first four will be with the first finger in the bass and start on the second note of the scale here, the C note with the little finger, and play. And then move that last note, which is the key, A for A minor pentatonic, from the sixth string to the fifth string, start on the second note in the scale, and play the scale here, play the melody here. So far, importantly, there's no change in that pattern at all. I just moved it towards the floor one string. When I move that A to the fourth string next, as I go up, whenever I hit a note on the second or first string in relation to the four bass strings, I have to move up a fret. So this pattern, which ended with the first and third finger, here I have to move up one fret that way when I play the last two notes, because they're on the second string. Then I play the pattern here, and the scale goes. And now where the pattern originally went like this, with the first finger on the same fret on all strings, when I do it here, I have to move up one fret when I hit the second string, that so that first finger doesn't go across here. It has to go up one fret for the second and first string, so the scale goes. And the melody starts on the second note of that. So that's the four octaves at this angle, and the last three are at this angle, and the scale, this is fingering five in the bass, this pattern, and I'm starting on the second note of the scale. Playing the same thing with the key in the bass on the fifth string instead of the sixth string A, it's fifth string. And this finger's better with the third finger there. And this is fingering three area. We're down in the base of that pattern here. Starting, there's the key, starting on the second note of the scale here. And you can see that I'm reaching one fret to the left on the third string, because remember, that's how the pattern goes. Third low and second high in that pattern, starting on this note. And then put that note on the fourth string and start on the second note of the scale. And now again, when I hit the second string previously, I would go like this, back a fret. Remember back here, I went like, I had to move a fret to the left, because here the fourth and third were low like this. But when I do that here, that move would have been here. But since the first two strings are tuned flat, I move those two notes up. So it kind of aligns everything now comfortably, so I just play this, which is the top of fingering one. Okay, that's it. That's seven octaves of I'm Your Hoochie Coochie Man. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Yay!